There are things in Nevada that are known around the world, but there's one thing that's known to just about no one. Now, they say in life, timing is everything, as you shall soon see.
About 2 hours north of Las Vegas, just off the 95 in the Amargosa Valley, is an amazing recreational area, a massive collection of sand mounds appropriately called Big Dune. These dunes cover 5 miles and at the highest point stand 500 feet tall. And most people come out here to ride off-road vehicles, but there's also another group who meet out here once a year for a different reason. Today, I met with Corey from the Bureau of Land Management to learn more about what's going on out here at Big Dune.
What do you do, Corey? Like, what's your job title?
My job title is wildlife biologist for the BLM. And so I work in the Pahrump Field Office, which is like the Nye County part of the Southern Nevada District. And so what I do a lot of time is do like NEPA work. We do a lot of wildlife surveys for snails, beetles, do some bird work too, but a lot of it is like tortoise conservation because that's like our big endangered species that we have.
Sure is great to walk around an area like this with a biologist. Corey was able to point out so many things I never would have noticed.
Corey, tell me about this area because it's dramatic, even by Nevada standards.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is a Big Dune out in the Amargosa Valley. There's lots of cool areas out here, but the Big Dune is definitely a huge attraction, not only for wildlife lovers, but for the recreation. And these are kind of just big islands of sand out in the middle of the desert.
Something very specific, very exciting, very precise happens here. Tell me about it.
Yeah, so each night from about mid-April to early May, Giuliani Dune Scarab beetles emerge every evening to mate in order to, you know, pass on their genes to the next generation.
So they literally come up out of the ground.
Yeah.
They go through a mating ritual.
Mm-hmm.
And then what happens?
So yeah, once they come up and breed and mate, the females, if they've successfully mated, will bury themselves back into the sand and then just stay in the sand dune, laying one egg per day for approximately 45 days and until their energy just completely wipes out and then they die in the sand. But the males, we think, will just come up night after night just looking for more and more females, or at least trying to find a female to successfully breed with.
And then they die as
and
well.
Then, yeah, so they'll just keep coming up until they run out of energy.
And then the next year, the eggs have hatched and they come out, it's their turn.
Yeah, so what's kind of crazy is we aren't totally sure if it's like the females lays an egg and then the pupa will come out the next year. But we think actually is the female will lay an egg. The larva may stay in the sand dune for up to 3 to 4 years and then pupate and then come up. So the beetles that we're seeing tonight may be 4 or 5 years old. We don't really know.
Does this happen anywhere else?
No, so this is the only place in the world where you can find Giuliani Dune Scarab beetle here at Big Dune and at Lava Dune. There's only two other species in the genus, and those occur way down south in Southern California and into Mexico.
Now, there will be others joining us tonight, right?
Yeah, absolutely. We've got about 13 other people coming out here from multiple different agencies, from the Park Service, NDAO, Nevada Natural Heritage, and more people from the BLM coming out here to help us conduct surveys so we can figure out what part of the sand dunes these beetles are using, where they're breeding on the sand dunes, so that we know which areas of the sand dunes to conserve.
Amazing. The tension is mounting because it's getting a little bit late. Others are coming in. Let's go set up.
Okay, awesome.
Time was of the essence, as the Giuliani beetle is on a pretty tight schedule. The group assembled, and Corey took the lead to walk everyone through the details and their responsibilities. The study is well organized and really interesting. Members of the group were assigned a section of an established grid. The grid covered the entire Big Dune area. The team fanned out to their section of the grid, and while in their area, each person would detail the amount of beetles emerging from the sand and how many would be within their grid. Each location with a concentration of beetles would be tagged with GPS coordinates. Corey and I made our way out to our assigned section. It's time to get to work. We carefully walked the area looking for a pocket of activity. When we found one, we settled in.
Corey, what is this? What are we looking for?
So
what?
Right there is a Giuliani beetle getting ready to emerge from the sand. So right now, all that we're seeing is the top of the head with its little antenna sticking up And all it's doing right now is just waiting for the sun to go down enough for it to think it's like the right lighting conditions for it to emerge from the sand dune for the night and fly off and look for a mate.
And there are hundreds of these in this area.
Yeah, right now. So it's, you see, I was like super well camouflaged, right?
Right.
So right now there's probably 1,000 of these guys spread out all over these small sand dunes, just waiting for right at like 7 o'clock or whenever they think the lighting's right.
It's very still right now, but when the time is right, you'll just see them come alive, mm-hmm. come out, and then I guess presumably they all will, and yeah. then the party's on.
Exactly. So what'll happen is he or she will emerge from the sand, take off flying, and then all of a sudden you'll like look around and there'll probably be like 10 or 20 other ones flying around in this area.
So the way that I can help you is to look for more of this.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, he's slow. He's just waking up.
The sun continued to set and the beetles continued to reveal themselves. And then it was time. And before you knew it, the sun set and the Giuliani beetles disappeared back into the sands of the Big Dune.
Corey, I got to tell you, that was phenomenal. I mean, the things I saw, the things I learned, it was incredible. How was it for you?
I think we had a very successful night. I'm really going to be really excited to see what everyone else saw. But just on the small dune we were on, we saw probably over 100 beetles, plus a mass emergence event, which was really cool. We saw multiple mating pairs and mating balls. So to me, it seems like we had a really successful night, and it tells me that we have a pretty healthy population here at the dune, which is really good to see.
Really good to see. Sounds like you got some good data that you can build on.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Having you guys here was really awesome, and being able to spread the word and help me out tonight was really great.
How about we see you again next year?
I'll take your help. Yeah, that'd be awesome.
I'll be here.
Okay.
Let's go.